Hi and welcome to ISBI. In this video I show you how to make push blocks which you can use for your router table, your table saw or even for a planer. First, I take the cutout piece from my router table and cut it to two identical pieces. These pieces will be the bottoms of the push blocks. Then I cut them to the right length on the miter saw. Here I try to figure out what are the perfect dimensions of the handles, so that they fit ergonomic in my hands. I draw the shape of one handle on plywood. For the radiuses, I try several round-shaped items like washers, cans, and so on. For an ergonomic handling, I give the handle a slight angle. Because I want the handle to be more ergonomic, I use a tape roll to draw a curve to it. Then I cut out two identical pieces on the miter saw. I use the bandsaw to cut out the drawn handle. Then I use the cutout handle to transfer the shape to the other piece and cut it out also. I set up my router table fence and round off all the pieces. Here I realize that the radius is too small for the handles, so I use a bigger radius bit. Time to glue the handles to the bottoms. I set the handle on a slight angle on the bottoms and mark the position. Then I glue them together. Because I want to reinforce the connection, I use dowels to do so. I sand the rest of the dowels away and round off the last edges. The last thing to do is to attach a piece of anti-slip mat to the bottom of the push blocks. I do that with double-sided tape. Here I test the push blocks to see if the friction is big enough. I think they will work very well. You can also use a wooden hand float like this and just attach a piece of anti-slip mat to it. That's the easy way.
Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please subscribe, give it a thumb up, share, and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!